Hey everyone, this is Brandon from Gaucho Plugins, the development team behind Domain Mapping System. In the last video, I configured all the DNS records I need for my new domain. I already configured the A record to point to my website hosting server, so now all I need to do is install WordPress. I'll log into my hosting control panel dashboard. Keep in mind, you might have a different dashboard provided by your hosting company. cPanel is really common among major web hosts, and I like its ease of use and flexibility. If you purchased your web hosting using your domain in the signup process, then you shouldn't need to add your new domain to your hosting control panel. If your new domain is an add-on, subdomain, or alias of your primary domain, the next video will cover configuring those options. The new domain I purchased in the first video of this series is going to be an alias, but for most people who haven't set up WordPress yet, I'll spend the rest of this video setting up my WordPress install. To install WordPress, we'll go into Softaculous, an awesome tool for installing hundreds of open source applications of all kinds. WordPress is featured on top, so I'll click Install. You have to configure some basic settings here, such as your site name, description, admin username, and password. At the bottom, you can choose to email your installation details to yourself. Click Install, and within a few seconds, your WordPress website should be working properly. If you've already configured DNS, you shouldn't have any further DNS configuration to do. If you're adding multiple domains to a single hosting instance, the next video covers how to set up add-on domains, subdomains, and aliases.